Buying on Yeezy Supply could be super frustrating. Trust me, I've been there. Yeezy Supply is a brand new format that everyone must know about, man. In this video, I'm going to increase your chances of having a successful cop on Yeezy Supply. That is a guarantee. I'm gonna give you guys some of my secret tips I use to cop on Yeezy Supply. I've been kind of successful lately. I done copped the March 350s. I done copped the Black Reflectives on Black Friday. I done bought about 5 to 6 pairs off Yeezy Supply, so I know what I'm talking about. But I wanna warn you guys, this is not a jig, this is not a finesse. No bots are needed, so if you want like an easy shortcut, I can't help you out. This will be done manually and honestly. My name is James Raw. If you want to stay up to date on Yeezy news, reviews, and updates, make sure you subscribe to this channel. Number one, Yeezy Supply has two types of drops: shop drops and scheduled release drops. But one thing about both of these drops that they have in common is that they are all random. Shop drops are random, and also the scheduled releases are random as well too. So if you want to start copping successfully on Yeezy Supply, you're going to have to start following some sneaker link accounts. These accounts, of course, will be on Twitter. Two accounts that I heavily rely on Twitter is Sneaker Shouts and Adidas Alerts. Anytime a sneaker goes live, these two Twitter accounts always post the launch links, always, right then and there. So what you're gonna do is follow these accounts on Twitter and turn your notifications on. So as soon as you hit that notification on your phone, you can just hit those links and it'll take you straight to the Yeezy Supply page, which is crucial. This is crucial because they usually send you the launch link about 15 times before the sneakers actually go live. And this is important because Yeezy Supply has a new format. Before, on Yeezy Supply, you can just put the sneaker in size, then you'll be put inside the splash page and see if you're able to cop or not. The new format is that you're in the waiting room. So the best thing is you want to be in this waiting room as early as possible. The earlier you're in this waiting room, the better. It will increase your chances of copping a sneaker a lot. The second tip is you want to be patient. Every sneaker launch is not the same on Yeezy Supply. Some sneakers sell out in a matter of minutes. Some sneakers sell out in a matter of hours, depending on the technical difficulties the website is going through. For the March 350s that just dropped, it literally took me an hour and a half to cop. I was in the waiting room for an hour and a half. And I'm glad I didn't give up, because if I would have gave up, I would have never copped the sneaker. So my advice to you guys is that don't give up unless you see the sold out message on the webpage. I'm telling you, man, you don't want to be a quitter. And the third tip is use multiple devices. I'm not saying having multiple pages on the computer is wrong or it's not the way to go, but it just seems that I don't have no success copping on Yeezy Supply doing it that way. So what I usually do is that I have one page up on the desktop, I got one up on the laptop, I got one on my phone, I got a page up on my girlfriend's phone, and I also have a page up on my iPad. Yes, I'm dead serious. In the past 12 months, I have hit at least one of those devices, man, and I just have better success with that. And the last tip is you wanna hurry up and buy as soon as possible. What I mean by that is that when it's actually your turn to buy, you wanna put in all your information as fast as possible. Just because you got through don't mean that your sneakers gonna sit there and wait for you. What I do is that I use the Google Chrome web browser. I use that web browser because it gives you the opportunity to do an autofill. Basically, you go under the options on your web browser and you can basically put all your information in. So when it's time for you to put in all your information, when you know, trying to buy the sneakers, it will autofill all your information for you. You can literally cop in seconds. And also keep in mind is that when you put in all your information, you want to have your billing address the same as your shipping address, because Yeezy Supply are supposedly trying to fight bots. So when you have two different addresses, it looks suspicious to them. I don't know why, but it just does. So if you do put two different addresses, you would get like another email later in the day saying that they're gonna refund your money and they're gonna take the sneakers away from you because you look shady, and you don't want that to happen. That's happened to me twice. So there goes my Yeezy Supply tips for you guys. I really hope you guys are able to cop on the next release, and let me know if you find anything helpful in this video. Make sure you holler at me in the comments. Make sure you hit the like button. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and look out for your boy. Thank you guys so much for checking out this video. I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.